What's up, guys? Today I'm going to show you how you can generate Pinterest pins from any Instagram page. So if you have an Instagram profile that's doing really well, or any Instagram profile that you'd like to use to generate Pinterest pins from, so you can transfer your marketing strategy from Instagram to Pinterest nice and easily, this is the perfect video for you. So we're going to jump straight into it. Let's have a look at this Instagram account here. This is just a random account I found, and they sell jewelry. They're called Sweet Willow Jewelry. They have a bunch of images showcasing golden rings and earrings, and we want to create Pinterest pins from this. So traditionally we would use pin generator, and we would simply take the URL of their Instagram page and click generate pins. But a number of websites have certain securities and certain blocks in place that prevent you from using the images directly from there. So we can see here that it's unable to detect the images from that Instagram page because of certain security measures. So the way to get around this and to get hold of those images is to use the Pin Generator Chrome extension. So that's a really useful tool that helps you to get images from any web page now, regardless of security, and you can use them in your Pinterest marketing campaigns. So we can see that this was only able to get one image, but if we go back and we want to get the images here, so what we need to do is install the Pin Generator Chrome extension. Now, it's over here in the Chrome store. I'm going to leave all the links down below, so if you want to grab the links, you can grab them there. It's in the Chrome store, pin generator here. Basically, this is a little demo of what it does. It allows you to scan any page and grab the metadata and images from it, and then you can generate ready-to-go Pinterest pins. That's a really fast way for you guys to make Pinterest pins from any Instagram account. Now, so the version that's in the Chrome Web Store here is not the latest version. The latest one is pending review. So for now, I'm going to show you guys how to install it from a zip file, which has the latest version. But in a day or two, this should be up to date. So I'll put the link for this below and the link for the latest download zip file. So here's the link for the zip file. What you're going to do is you're going to copy that, put it into your URL section, and it'll show what's in it. We're going to download it. So we'll download this. Lovely. Then we're going to extract it, and then we can see we've got it here in our desktop. So go back to the extensions page. You can go here by going by clicking on this little puzzle piece in your right-hand corner, and you can go manage extensions, or you can go to the URL chrome:// extensions. Now, to install something from a zip file, we got to turn on developer mode here, which is in the top right. So just toggle that on, and then click load from unpacked. So we load from unpacked, and we're going to go to the desktop, find the pin generator hyphen Chrome extension, and click select. So that's going to load the extension in. You can see it here. This is version 0.02, whereas the one on the store is 0.01. So you can see that we've gone up a version. And yeah, so now it's in there. So now you'll see that when you click on your little puzzle piece here, there'll be an option for pin generator. So let's pin that so that it's visible at all times now. Right, let's go back to here, back to Instagram, and we can see all these pictures we want to get. So let's refresh the page. So I use Command Shift R to refresh and clear the cache so that the page that we're working with is completely fresh, as well as that helps reload the new Chrome extensions into that web page. So we've done that, and now we can click on the Chrome extension and we can click scan page. So you'll see here it's got the title of the page, it's got the URL, it's got the description, and all of these are editable. So if you wanted to change these up, you could. And then it's got a whole bunch of images from the web page that are available to you now. So you can select the ones you like, or you can select them all, you can deselect them all. But let's grab a couple of nice ones. Let's select that one, that one. I kind of like these lifestyle ones. I like these close-ups of the gold, and I like that one, some of these lifestyle ones. Lovely. So I like those. Cool. And once we're happy, we can also change these, so we can say gold rings. Let's say that's our title, and we can change up our description. So beautiful gold rings. I'm just going to do a real short one to save you guys time. And then when we're happy with that, we can click generate pins. So this will take you back to pin generator, and it'll have all those images and information for you generated into pins. So we can see that this is all generated with that immediately. Don't mind my logo here. That's my logo. So let me just remove that, make life easier. Cool. So yeah, now that you have your images and data in and you've got a whole bunch of pins generated, you can go to the detected images and you can manage the images you want to use here. Let's say you've got one that you didn't like. You could perhaps, you know, just remove that one and then it'll update accordingly. So if you've got a set title also, a really great thing to do is to go to AI and you can simply rewrite the titles with AI. And so these ones don't have a lot of variety. Shimmering rings, shimmering gold bands, but you get the idea. So you can do the same with descriptions, and if you wanted to edit all of the titles or descriptions at the same time, you could do so here. You can say awesome gold rings, and it'll do that there. So you get the idea. So I'm going to save those overrider titles, and of course you can edit these guys one by one if you like. You can edit the outbound link to Pinterest. And once you're happy designing everything, you know, you can select templates too, of course. You can select a whole bunch of templates that you like. But yeah, there's loads of design options. And once you're happy, you can schedule the pins to your Pinterest account. Or you can pin the pins directly, or you can download them for later. It's really up to you. There's loads of options. So the crux of it is that by using this, you can generate Pinterest pins from any website, especially with those that have been problematic in the past for fetching images and whatnot. So this is a really great way to take your Instagram stuff, your Instagram images and your marketing campaign there, and put it onto Pinterest. Nice, quick and easy. So yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoy it. Let me know if you've got questions down below, and I'll see you in the next one.